G'day, I'm Warwick Schiller, and a couple of years ago I put up a video about what to do with horses that bite or nip. And the whole thing was, I've realized, is that horses that bite and nip, usually they are trying to get you to engage with them. They're not actually trying to bite you. If you think about horses, when they engage with things, they engage it with their muzzle, and they're kind of like, hey, pay attention to me. A lot of times you'll be, you know, putting the saddle on or whatever, and they'll reach around and nip you. And if you think about it, for the most part, you are not present. You're not aware of what they're doing, and out of the blue, you get bit. And what that video was about was, if you can engage with those horses as their head comes around towards you, reach out with your hands and engage with them and rub them around the muzzle. And initially you might have to be careful you don't get bitten if they've got a habit of biting you, but really that whole habit of swinging the head around there is trying to engage with you. And I've had a number of people who've said they've had a couple of different problems, and one of the problems is they say, well, he bit me on the knee, okay? And what you've got to be able to do there is think about, if their head comes towards you, your hands are like a baseball catcher or a cricket wicket keeper, to where your hands go to where the head is. So if his head comes around your knee, have your hand go down there. If his head comes here, have it go there. If his hands go to your hat or your cap or your hair, put your hands up there and just keep your hands between your body and his mouth. And the other one is people that say, I tried to do that, but he keeps flinging his head up and taking his head away. And the thing with that is those people are thinking they're supposed to engage with them. It's only when they're trying to engage with you. And we've got a horse here, my wife's new reining horse, Ray, who you'll see more of. And I was messing with him the other day and videoing some stuff, and this came up. So I'll show you what it almost looks like in a real life situation. You know, doesn't act that really shut down. Hey dude, how's it going? Are you good? Is he good? You're a good little man. Oh yes. He's trying to get. How's it going? Are you good? Yeah. You bumped your head on something today outside playing with the other ponies over the fence? Bumped your head twice. Look at you. You're a mess. Now, if you're engaging with them like this and they go to pull their head away, I've had some people say, I was trying to engage my horses, but he keeps throwing it up in the air and won't let me engage with it. Like right there, if he wants to move it away, let him move it away. Okay? It's not about engaging with him. It's about engaging with him when he wants to engage with you, like that. Okay? If he wants to come over here, I will hang here and go, hey dude, how's it going? Are you having a good day? But right there, my hands stay here and he goes away. If he wants to come back, I'll engage with him again. But it's not about trying to make them engage you. It's about every time they want to engage with you, you are there. There he goes, in big licking shoe. That's the first one. You are there to engage with them. There he goes, a big licking shoe. Should they feel the need to do so. But it's not about, you're not trying to rub them forever. Like if they want to come over here, you're going to engage with them. The other thing some people say is, my horse wants to nibble on my jeans or nibble on my hat or whatever. There's a big yawn. This is all very good here. Very good. Wherever their mouth goes, your hand goes. Okay? So if his mouth comes here, my hands go there. If his mouth went to my knees, my hands would go down to my knees. If his mouth came to my hat, my hands would go here. There you go. He's rolling his third eyelid back, having a big lick and a chew. What a good little man you are. And that's, you know, we've had him for a couple of weeks now, and he definitely didn't do that when we first got him, but he didn't engage with you much when we first got him either, so. Oh yes, another big yawn. Big yawn. And that little session right there might be all I do with him for right now. I've been doing a lot of this. You know, we've just been at a horse show for about 10 days, and you just go, and sometimes I go in his stall and sit down there, and he might stand in the corner, eat his hay, and I might sit on the bucket, and he might come over after a while and come and say hi. He might not. But I've spent a lot of these little interactions with him, just letting him know that just letting him know that I see his his change in focus, and he's, I think he's starting to come out of his shell quite a bit.